Hi everyone, this is Mayank Kothari, and today in this video we are going to discuss about how to revise the entire subject of strategic financial management in just 3 days. Almost 15 days are left for the exam, and old syllabus and new syllabus, both people are going to appear in this exam. New syllabus, it's going to be the first attempt. Last like a couple of days, not just couple of days, yesterday itself I asked all the people, all my subscribers on YouTube to vote that how many days you can give for SFM preparation for this May 2018 exam, and most of the people voted that we have, sir, only 3 days allotted for SFM. Like, I got around 883 votes out of that. 72%, if I calculate, almost 635 people said that we have only 3 days. We can allocate only 3 days for SFM, like in the coming 15 days. So a lot of people might be having both groups, 8 subjects, and a lot of people might be having single group itself. Doesn't matter. There are some tips for old syllabus and new syllabus students. The very first thing is, I will give you a plan of 2 days. Okay, what to do in those 2 days, and for 1 day, I'm going to allocate these 1 day over a period of 10 to 15 days, 10 to 12 days at least. You have to do that. For the first 2 days, I will suggest you, if you are old syllabus student or new syllabus student, doesn't matter, stick to your reference book. If you have joined classes somewhere, if you have used my video lectures, if you have not joined classes or video lectures or anything and studying by self, stick to that reference book. Use only your class material if you have not started with the practice manual and not comfortable with the practice manual. Don't jump on the practice manual right now. So ultimately what I want to say is, stick to your material, class notes, reference book, or otherwise practice manual. If the preferable for me is the practice manual, skip all the class notes. If you haven't done this practice manual, because a lot of people says that practice manual sums are covered in the class notes, so we have already done the class notes only, so is it necessary to do the practice manual right now? It is not. Don't jump on it if you have not done it before. So either it will be practice manual, either it will be your class notes, so whatever you started with, and you have only 2 days to complete that notes. First thing to accept is, you cannot do all the questions, neither from the practice manual nor from your class notes, regular batch notes or something like that. Only if you have the fast track notes or some crash batch you have joined in your city, you might be able to do those questions, and you should do it, provided it covers all the concepts. This is one thing. Okay, so accept that you cannot do all the questions. So never make this mistake. You will lose your time and the important chapter, because after you will run out of your time, you won't be able to do that important chapter. So the thing is, do selective questions. I'm repeating this thing, do selective question from your class note, reference book, practice manual, or fast track batch, or the important question list that I have provided everyone a month or 2 months before. Anything, but do selective questions only. If you are going to let's take an example of practice manual capital budgeting chapter. Forget about capital budgeting, let's take for both syllabus, foreign exchange and risk management chapter. Entire chapter is applicable to old syllabus and new syllabus from the practice manual. And if you are able to, if you are thinking of doing all the questions from the practice manual, you might be able to do all the questions from practice manual, but you will have to skip couple of chapters at the end of the day. And around 13 chapters are there in the old syllabus and 17 chapters are there in new syllabus. You won't be able to complete it entirely. So the first tip, do selective questions. Sir, what kind of questions we should do? In the first reading or the second reading that you might have done earlier in the class, or February, or let's say March, you might have marked some important questions, the difficult ones also, that you were not able to solve. Those questions are covered in the important question that you have to do in these 2 days. Otherwise also, what is the meaning of important question or selective question? It's same. It's the only thing that minimum questions, the list of minimum questions which covers maximum concepts. So you have to focus on the concepts while doing those questions. If you are doing the important question list that I have provided to everyone, that will be sufficient enough to do in those 2 days. Make sure you don't make this mistake of just finding out the answer. Okay, this question, I can do it easily. This is the formula-based question. If you are not able to recollect the entire concept while doing that question, you are just following the wrong approach. It doesn't make any sense wasting that time also. Just sit and watch some videos on YouTube. Don't do that. Just focus on the concept. After doing that particular question, you should be able to understand and tell yourself that, okay, I have understood the concept. Okay. So, in these 2 days, you will be only able to do this. Okay. After that, what to do? Trust me, second thing that you should apply or believe is, forget about the fear, how the paper is going to be. Because while doing these questions, while revising in these 2 days, if you are nervous, if you are scared, if you are not confident, your mind will not work. This is human, okay? This is human thing. Your mind will not work. You will not be able to recollect that formula. You will not be able to apply that formula. You will not get the answer to that question. If you're not going to get the answer, you will get nervous, you will panic, and you will be like, oh my god, I'm not going to clear the exam now. I think I should go for November attempt. Just forget these crap. Second thing, be confident. Whatever you have done, if there are 200 concepts in the entire subject and you have not touched like around 20 to 30 concepts, just skip it. Don't worry about it. You have no time to start something new. Don't do new questions. Don't go for the new concept. Like only couple of or 4 or 5 concepts or 10 concepts are there and you can spend time on going through that. Then only you should go for it. Otherwise, don't start something new. Just revise what you have already done. Okay. So while doing that, you will be able to recollect the formulas and all that thing. So you will be confident enough. So in 2 days, you have these two things that you have to do. Selective questions. Okay. Second thing. I will tell you, this is the list of important questions that I have provided to everyone. If you are doing it, then it's all fine. Otherwise, also at least focus on the chapters. These are the chapters from your syllabus. And this is for old syllabus. I will obviously tell that who all people can use this important question list from the new syllabus student for which chapters. For the new syllabus student, you can skip these three chapters. There are some portion of dividend decision which is also covered in security evaluation, but right now you can skip it. You can cover the security evaluation from somewhere else. Portfolio management, derivatives, these chapters are seriously important for the new syllabus student. This is also skipped. So four cross marks are there which the new syllabus student should not refer to these chapters. Otherwise, they can refer this chapter and they should, in fact, to revise the entire syllabus. Apart from these chapters, for the new syllabus student, there are some theory chapters that you should do from your short notes. Okay, coming back to the topic. First thing, selective questions. Second thing, don't be nervous and don't panic. This is how you are going to spend your 2 days, okay? Rely on these questions. Even if you are doing 100 questions, trust on those 100 questions from your class notes, reference book, or the video lecture note, or this important question list, whatever it is. Trust on that and believe and just skip it. Don't worry about how it is going to be. Have faith in yourself. Third thing, the third day. Okay, I'm not allotting the entire day for SFM now, for the third day. What I'm going to request is that now, after 2 days, every day you should, before going to bed, you should revise the formula sheets, the charts you might have received with the video lectures that I have provided, with the class notes that you might have done somewhere else, or some formula sheets that you have already with you. There, it is very necessary that at the end of the day, if you close your eyes, if I can think of the portfolio management chapter, I should be able to recollect from where that chapter is starting and where it is ending. This is necessary. You have to revise at least 1 hour a day before going to bed. Revise all the chapters through charts. Okay, I will tell you an example. This is the old syllabus charts that I have provided to the students, and also this is the new syllabus chart. There are 15 charts in the new syllabus. You should use this every day. Okay, this particular tip is for the new syllabus student. Theory chapters, the weightage of theory is more in new syllabus. Okay, so around 25 to 30 marks of theory you can expect in the exam. How to do that theory? Don't go with the books. I am telling you, don't go with the books at this point. You are not going to complete it. The time is not that enough with you. Go with the charts. Every theory, every important theory, I can say 95% of the theory is covered in the charts. That's why from 5 charts to 15 charts it has been. This is only for the video lectures, people. So this is like Indian financial system, the first, second chapter. In exam, it might ask you to give the difference between the bank based and market based system, financial system. So you will be easily able to understand it if you have revised these charts. Okay, otherwise also, if you don't have the charts, you should go with the summary notes or the formula sheets every day, 1 hour before going to bed. So this is the third thing. This is how you should be able to complete. Now, in the entire plan, what I have suggested to you, what I have covered, I made sure that you are covering at least all the concepts at least once. I made sure that you are focusing on concepts, not just the solution. I made sure that there should be a picture of the entire chapter in your mind by doing the revision. Now, this is for the new syllabus that I'm telling you. There are 17 chapters for the new syllabus students. Make sure that you are focused, you are aware of the weightage of those chapters. If you can see here, first 3 chapters have only 5 to 10% of the weight, means hardly one question is going to ask. Is going to be asked in the exam. One question may be on the value at risk concept, or the other question might be on theory. Otherwise, both question can be from theory. But the most important chapters starts from here: security analysis to the mergers and acquisition. All the chapters are important in this. Like, obviously, sir, you have covered everything in this and you're saying this is important. Yeah, obviously, because average weights are given to all the chapters, 20 to 30, 20 to 25 and 20 to 30. Last, mergers and acquisition and corporate valuation is almost like similar chapters. So it's been given 10 to 15 percentage. And in the end, last 3 chapters are also given 5 to 10%. That is only for the theory purpose. Okay, one thing that I want to correct in the study material, there is a mistake in the definition of startup. In the definition of startup, it is given 5 years in the study material, but it has been changed and it is now 7 years. Just type startup definition or startup.gov.in. I think some Startup India Initiative, as this is something like a website. Just go to Google and go to that official website. You will get to know that what is the changed number of year in the definition. So 5 years is the old one, 7 years is the new one. Okay. So this is it. I think this will be enough and this is going to surely help you a lot in your preparation. 1.5 days before exam, make sure that you are doing the revision test paper, you are doing the important questions, and you are revising the charts and formula sheets before going to the exam. Second thing is, make sure that if you have any kind of question to ask me, you can ask me in the comment box. I will reply to all the questions for 2 days from the date of posting this video. After that, I won't be able to check on that video. Even if you have any kind of question later on also, you can WhatsApp me at 89834-75152. I will just note it down. It's 89834-75152. Make sure I'm replying to the doubts in 48 hours. So there are almost 100 to 150 doubts I'm solving every day, and it's practically not possible to solve all the doubts in single day. That's why I'm telling you that after you post the last thing in our chat, wait for 48 hours and you will get the reply. This is only till exam. So this is it. This is all about how to prepare the entire SFM in 3 days just before the exam. So it's 15 days. Make sure that you are confident, and all the best for your exam. I hope you are going to be successful in your exam, in the entire papers, not only SFM. I wish all the best to all of you people. So bye bye.